Okay guys, we're back. This is episode 37 of Modern Online. This is Fun Gaming Connoisseur, and just continuing from where I left off. Actually, I think this is episode 38. previous episode was episode 37. Okay, I'm not sure why we're going to the slums, but... Okay, so I think he's going to the slum bank. I think this is it's kind of like a, you know, it's going to be a whole bunch of people traveling together, which is fun, I reckon. Be a long line of cargo and being shipped from one place to another. Thank you. He's got the Tindremic Lictor armor. Okay, so it appears that if you're seen wearing the Tindremic Lictor armor, you know, the guards might pounce on you, I think. Which is another thing that, you know, adds a lot of, yeah, it's a very nice dynamic in this game, is that the guards do search players for any items that they may deem to be illegal. Okay, so we've got Pernix, got a Luke, and Seeing Red. Yeah, it's a very nice name, you know, when they see red they just, yeah, they charge forward. And Vendane. Good thing this guy's friendly. I wouldn't want to be, you know, wouldn't want something like this to charge down on me and knock me down. It'll be a painful knockdown. So for those of you who are, you know, who are wondering what else they can do in this game once they've maxed out their skills and attributes, try and look for something like this to do. You know, maybe not necessarily fighter escort, but try and think of something that you want to do as a career. Maybe think of something that you want your character to be known for. And you know, pursue it, because this game is all about doing what you want and being what you want. And it's weird, this guy's yeah, it's very cool, this game, you know, definitely, you can definitely do a lot of things in this game that, you know, you can't do in a lot of other MMOs. Okay, so... Okay, so we're on our way. This is my first ever fighter escort duty. You know, I'm definitely having a lot of fun now, even though it's just the start. And we got brick wall, Vendane. So we got a lot of guys and a lot of pets, which is good. You know, definitely makes me feel safe. Yeah, if we come across a lone murderer, we can definitely. Well, I think most likely we'll be able to take them down. So. Yeah, my throat's very dry today, so you know, having a bit of a difficulty in commentary, but it's all good. I don't know whether I can keep up with these guys. Just saw a guy. Saw him casting a spell. Blazed Bob seems to be ahead most of the time. He seems to be in front, but I think I'll follow Duthrin. Yeah, I gotta have someone to follow. Otherwise, I just end up following anyone in the group, and so. Yeah, I read somewhere that it, if pets are going uphill, their speed is slowed down. But doesn't seem to be the case. It seems as like seems as though their speed is still very constant. Yeah, this is definitely a different path that they're taking to go to Vadda. Normally when I'm going to Vadda, I would just head more east and then head south after that. You know, when I get into the grasslands. But anyhow. I don't know, man. I don't know whether I can go down there and survive. Definitely like this two-handed mace. It feels very, very nice in my hands, and it's a nice feeling when I swing it. Oh. Okay. Thought I lost them. man. Yeah, the Belbuses, yeah. They look very disturbed. Okay, so I'm gonna be protecting Vendane. Yeah, I am starting to notice that when I'm in combat mode, my stamina regenerates very quickly, so I think I will stay in this mode for the remainder of this trip. And there's Blazed Bob. So we've just killed a RPK guild, a member of that guild, and there's Duthrin. Okay, so I've got to stick with Vendane. Still here. I thought I lost them. I wonder if there's a dance emote. Never mind. I was gonna see whether there's a emote to dance. There's a, you know, Love Shack. There's that song called the Love Shack. Okay, I think the reason why they're taking a different route, maybe they're trying to avoid other guild patrols. Maybe, you know, some RPK guilds, maybe they patrol certain areas, so I don't know, maybe they're just trying to avoid going to those areas. By the way, guys, yeah, for some of you who are wondering whether you need to be in a guild to have fun in this game, in my opinion, you don't necessarily need to be in a guild, because I've been playing this game for many months now as a solo player, as in ungilded, and I've been enjoying this game a lot. And right now, you know, you can play, you know, cooperate with other players without being in a guild. So that's one thing that is good about this game. So so if you want to be a solo, like a solo player, you can definitely do that, and it won't be less fun. I wonder how much damage this two-handed mace does. I would like to test it out sometime. Maybe I'll test it out in the Tindrem graveyard or something like that. Okay, so I think I will continue this in the next episode. So thanks for watching this episode today. I hope to see you in the next one. Take care.